guys, but the name may seem scary and long. I know this is the type of names they put in our mythology exam, so when we see it, we get scared and leave medicine and switch to engineering or art or whatever. But trust me, guys, it's really simpler than you think. I know that every single one of you guys know the disease, but you guys don't know the disease, but I know that you guys do. See what I did with the words there? Anyways, maybe the next slide should brighten things up. See? Everyone now recognizes what is this? This is the Ice Bucket Challenge. A campaign in 2014 was made to raise awareness and raise funds to fight ALS. So, what is ALS? ALS. So, what is ALS? ALS, or amyotrophic lateral sclerosis, or Lou Gehrig disease, is a motor neuron disease. And pay attention to motor neuron. It is not sensory, ladies and gentlemen. So, a motor neuron disease, which is basically what our brain uses to tell our muscles when to twitch or when to contract, starts degenerating, ladies and gentlemen. And that leads to horrible, horrible, horrible symptoms, such as severe muscle weakness, loss of control over the limbs, losing the ability to talk, to swallow, and even to breathe. Most patients die with respiratory failure. Patients diagnosed with ALS are expected to live from 3 to 5 years maximum. It's very rare, ladies and gentlemen, that a person with ALS has survived more than 10 years. And you know what makes it all worse? There is currently no cure for such a disease. Okay, before I move on, I want every single one of you to think with me how horrible of a disease this is. Remember when I told you it's only motor neurons that degenerate, not the sensory neurons? Do you know what that means? That means that our patient can feel everything around him. He can sense everything, but he can't do anything to respond. Imagine feeling everything around you. You see the people walk, you know what they are talking about. You have so much to say and so much to do, but you can't contract a simple muscle in response. This is a very, very horrible disease, ladies and gentlemen. One of the people who got ALS is this man right here, Stephen Hawking. Stephen Hawking was diagnosed with ALS at 20 years old at his first year at Cambridge University. So picture this. First year at college, and you get diagnosed with such a horrible disease, and doctors tell you that you will live from 3 to 5 years, and there is currently no cure for this disease. What normal people would do? They will just quit university, quit education, because what's the point? What's the point in studying if I'm going to die after 5 years? And they will just sit at their mama's house and wait for death to come at their way. But that's not what Stephen Hawking said. Stephen Hawking refused. He said no. He did not let a disease define who he is. Then he said, me and only me can define my future. I'm not gonna let a disease stand in the way of my dreams and my goals and achievements. He kept grinding. He continued studying. He kept working hard till he achieved what he did. Stephen Hawking, this man, is one of the brightest minds humanity has ever known. This guy is up there with Newton and Einstein. This guy is a phenomenon. He changed the modern physics. He won a lot of prizes. This guy changed the world from a wheelchair and electronic phone. So my fellow colleagues, what is stopping you? What is stopping every single one of you? I want you guys to ask this question. I know life can be hard. I know your relationship with your parents, maybe the university is hard. I know life can be hard, but no matter how hard life can be, it can never be as hard as living with ALS. So if Stephen Hawking with ALS could change the world, then I'm sure each single one of you guys can change the world. It just matters that we determine. This guy was diagnosed with ALS at 20 years old. He died with it at 74 years old. He survived 50 50 years with ALS. Call it a medical phenomenon. Call it a miracle. I don't care what you call it, but I will call it one thing and one thing only. Determination. Determination, ladies and gentlemen. Stephen Hawking once said, and however difficult life may seem, there's always something you can do and be good at. It just matters that you never give up. As long as there is hope, there is life, ladies and gentlemen. So, my fellow colleagues, there is nothing that can stop you. As long as you believe in the beauty and in the magic and in the colors of your dream and work hard to get it, there is nothing in life that can stop you. There is nothing in life that can stop you. Ladies and gentlemen, a determined human being mind is stronger than everything. A determined human being mind is stronger than everything. Thank you all very much.